There are many gaming laptops out there that caters to the casual gamer all the way to the hardcore gamer. But sadly, with these fancy gaming laptops, you do not have the option to choose the specs that come with this laptop. Well, that's where the Commandos Glock comes in. A laptop that is fully customizable from its display all the way to its processor based on your needs. And it comes with a very special feature that you will find out later in this video. So with that, guys, let's get on with the review. The overall design of the Glock is subtle. It does not scream gaming laptop, but at the same time, it does not look like your everyday regular laptop that you might be watching this video on. All it has is the Commandos logo on the top, which does not say much, but I must say, it is a pretty cool looking logo. When it comes to I/O, it gives you a very nice and complete set of ports. On one side, you have the Ethernet, USB 2.0 ports, as well as ports for a headphone and microphone, and a SD card reader. On the other side is a mini display port, HDMI port, a Type-C and two USB 3.0 ports. It practically gives you the option to extend this display to three other screens via the video ports and the Type-C port. There is also heat sinks that are positioned on the back towards the sides and on the left side of the laptop. Flipping up the laptop will reveal the 15-inch Full HD IPS screen, which I'm very satisfied with. The colors are great and the viewing angles are also excellent. Now, the one issue I have with gaming laptops is its keyboard, because sometimes some gaming laptops provide you with very small keycaps and a not satisfying travel distance for these keys. However, the Commandos Glock manages to overcome these issues by giving you a very decent size keycaps, and the travel distance is very satisfying to type. So regardless if I'm playing games or doing work on this laptop, the typing experience is very, very nice. Then we come down to the touchpad. Now, the touchpad on the Glock is using Windows Precision drivers, but sometimes I feel that the touchpad does not really recognize my gestures or my movements very well. However, this doesn't happen all the time, and it's not really a problem for me because I always carry a mouse with me.
Specs-wise, this laptop comes with a GeForce GTX 1050 Ti, 16GB of RAM, 256GB of SSD storage, and an Intel Core i5 8600K processor. That might sound fine to be a mid-range gaming laptop, but I remember, as I said, it was customizable. Well, just like the RAM and the hard drive, the processor can be changed if you need to, as it is a socketable CPU rather than a soldered on like other regular laptops. This not only gives you a longer reason to use it, but if any time you feel like you need more processing power, you could simply just swap out the processor and put a more powerful Intel processor on the board. But how does that translate to real-world use? Well, The Witcher 3 and No Man's Sky will give you 35 frames per second overall. PUBG and Fortnite have pretty decent frames as well, of 55 and 60 respectively. All the games were set to the highest graphic with AA turned off and the charger plugged in. Thanks to the heat sinks that surround the laptop, it has managed to cool down both the CPU and graphic cards to a safe and comfortable temperature. The processor maxes out at 55 degrees while the graphic card maintains 75 degrees with both on load. You might feel some heat around the WASD keys and towards the top of the keyboard, but that is barely noticeable, as once as I'm engrossed into a game, I totally forget about the heat. Now, this laptop comes with Creative Sound Blaster 5 software. The audio quality is not so great. Everything overall feels flat and there's no satisfaction from the audio, which is probably due to the speakers on this laptop. However, where the Creative software shines is when you connect a headphone, as this software allows for different types of tuning for your audio. Aside from the audio software, the Glock comes with its own Control Center 2.0, which allows you to monitor the laptop from its heats, fan speeds, to changing the brightness of the keyboard, putting the laptop in different power management modes, and customizing the speeds of the fan. Do note though that the fan can get really loud if you set the fan setting to maximum, but it does help in regulating the heat for the components.
When it comes to battery life, it is what you expect from a gaming laptop. On normal use of browsing the internet, watching a video, or just listening to some music, the laptop manages to last for about 4 hours. However, when it comes to gaming, that's where you need to expect a much lesser battery life, because this laptop can last roughly about 2 hours playing intensive games like Witcher and PUBG. So the times might vary depending on what game you are playing. For example, if you're playing a simple indie game, then this laptop can last slightly more than 4 hours.
The charger that comes with the laptop might be slightly big for some of you, but you'll be surprised by the weight of this charging brick because it's not actually that heavy. So for those of you that want to carry a charger around while you're using the laptop, all you need to do is just get a bigger bag and you probably won't even feel the weight of this charger. So guys, there you have it. That is the review of the Commandos Glock gaming laptop. Now, this laptop does not have a fixed price, mainly because it is a customizable laptop. So we have placed some reference price lists on the screen right now for you to compare for yourself. Now, the best way to find out the price of the laptop based on your specification is to send ArmoryX a message on their Facebook page. The links will be in the description below. Alright guys, so if you like this video, do give us a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not, because we take out videos like this every single week. And of course guys, I will see you in the next video.